Okay, good morning. It is about 8 a.m. and there's about 4 days left to the booth, and this is the match that I've prepared. This is all the 6mm bracelets, and then these are the crystal tassel bracelets, which is the same as this one. This one is basically like 33 beaded bracelet that can act as a tassel bag that you wear on your wrist. And then these are the daisy mask extenders that are like the best selling ones, but I have very little stocks because I'm running out of lobster claws. And I'm contemplating whether I should make more of the daisy mask extenders or should I make mask chains. These are the mask chains that I have, which is considered little because like this is also selling well. And those are all the dust bins that I made, which is considered very little because I need to fill them up and make more. For the packaging, I bought these two. This is a simple paper bag, while this is a craft bag. So this is for small purchases, while this is for people who buy more items, and then I'll fit them inside this paper bag. I bought this paper bag from SKP. It is about $5.10 for 100 pieces. For this paper bag, it's about 35 cents each. I bought 50 pieces. It's from Shopee, so I'll include the link down below. Here's another bracelet stand that I bought. I love the color and how the gold metal contrasts with the wood. And look at how soft it is. Okay, so this is how it is supposed to look like. I got it for $18 including shipping, and it actually has like no reviews, so I kind of like risk this purchase, but I mean the quality is not bad. I just want to fix it up and see how it goes. So it's literally like that. This is how this thing looks like. You just literally put these pieces, make sure they're straight, and then ta-da! Wow, took me less than 5 minutes, not even 2 minutes, but cool. And I'm actually really pleased with how this setup looks like in the plant there. Honestly, I put the plant there just so that it gets light, because this is the first time I'm taking care of a plant, and like I'm really upset at how it's turning out. I don't know whether I'm underwatering it, overwatering it. Like, how would I know? Can someone please tell me? But anyway, moving back to this, I really love it. The reason why I even got this was because it's much easier to insert the bracelets in, as well as if I need to take them out. For example, a customer wants to see this, I can like. It's much more easier as compared to the one that I have. Like for example, let me show you guys. For example, this one that I have here. The side is quite thick and it only fits like 18cm bracelets. So if I were to put smaller size bracelets, it will stretch, and I'm afraid this will cause it to lose its elasticity faster. So yeah, I guess this is a better option. So I kind of put them together just to see how it looks like. And as you can see, like just by one look, it's so messy and you can't even see the designs. So I'm actually thinking of removing the middle piece so that you can actually see all that. Or maybe I just fill it up with another type of bracelets. But yeah, I love how it looks without the bracelets. But I can't do that, if not I won't sell any of my bracelets. But yeah, I think maybe this was more suitable for like a ring display, but not much of a bracelet display because you can't see the designs. Again, this is something I'm still thinking of, how to allow the customers to be able to see the full design so that they don't have to like look through this and like guess whether they should get it or not, instead of like seeing it as a full, you know. Yeah, it's quite difficult to like actually see the individual designs when it's like put in a TBar display like this. Okay, so I'm gonna show a few items that I bought for like the display for the booth. I got this from Shopee. I can't remember how much was it. I'll include the price here and the link and whatsoever. But yeah, I was really pleased at how it only took 6 days to deliver. This booth was kind of last minute because like I only officially confirmed it on 11 December, which is like 12-ish days before the booth. Yeah, so yeah, I got this within 6 days. And this one is mainly for the task base. How I decided to display it is that this one,
this T-bar is taller, so I feel that it needs something that's longer down here, while this one is fine to just show a few bracelets. So this is how it looks like when I put the tasbihs and some bracelets on it. I also have this like grey T-bar stand, which I actually don't really like because the color grey doesn't match my branding. And yes, I'm very picky about my branding, but the color is kind of off from the vibe that I'm going for. I'm kind of going for like the neutral look. So this grey didn't really match, but I ended up using it for the booth itself because I was kind of desperate and I needed to show some bracelets that I didn't put up at first. Yeah, so this one, I bought it a long time ago when I didn't have proper branding yet. I'm actually considering to buy a similar stand, but it's wooden, beach-ish. Maybe next time I'll show you guys. But yeah, as of now, this is all that I have. And yeah, I also feel that the beach one that I'm planning to get will have more contrast because like the bracelets are brighter color, and then against a beach background, the color, for example pink, if I put on it, it will stand out better with that plain beach lighter color background as compared to the gray one. It is slightly like off and maybe I just don't like it. Yeah. So when I tell you guys that I want to share with you the journey of me setting up the booth and all this prep, I really want to bring you guys to the journey. So it's not only the stagnant times, but also the ups as well as the downs. And currently it's a Tuesday, my booth is on Thursday, and I am currently facing like kind of like a down today. Like it's been tough. I wouldn't say it's tough, but I guess it's just been pretty overwhelming. Like I've been working so hard since last week, and I guess I've been keeping it all in until today. I realized that okay, I think I've been doing too much, that I haven't gotten time to just sit down and like breathe or just take a moment to calm down or something. And part of me is just afraid of giving too much, of making too much that I can't sell the items. So this is where all the self-doubt and all that comes in. Thankfully, I have like my partner to just like motivate me despite these challenging thoughts and all that. And yeah, I do receive like DMs and all that telling me like all the best for your booth and all that. And I really appreciate those DMs. Like, you guys do know how much those messages mean to me. But apart from that, like, I think one thing that I realized, maybe I should put on the phone, so like, because I think I got a lot to share. So a reflection that I just had was about how for a second I thought that I've been doing so much, that I've been doing so many products basically, and as well as putting so much effort in all this. But I think that's the thing about us, we keep thinking about what we give to the society, to people, to, we just keep thinking about what we give out and how much we, it's just so much of the giving and like, oh, I'm not getting this instead or something like that. And I guess that's when we just have to take a pause to think back about what you have been receiving instead. So I guess like, yeah, that's a shortcoming that I realized, whereby I've been thinking too much about what I have, can give, but I don't realize about the things that I receive. So I guess from here, like a quick thought, like I receive the love from people around me. I managed to see that this is how much I can do, so I think it's a good thing that I get to see the strength that I have within me, and that itself is a gift from Allah, to be able to do so much. You know, like we keep thinking or we keep seeing as being overwhelmed as a bad thing, but we could also see as how Allah is actually just trying to show you your true potential.
I guess if we look more of opportunities instead of the otherwise of like what we don't get instead, then we will never ever be grateful. And that is something that in a way scares me, that if I'm not grateful to what God has given me. But I guess like times like this is needed to just sit down and reflect of what I'm grateful for, what I receive instead of what I give. Yeah. And I got reminded today, like whatever it is, like I will learn something from it. Even if my items don't sell or whatsoever, like then I know, okay, these items are not doing well as compared to these other items. So there's always, whatever that you go through, there's always something that you can take from it. And yeah, think about what you receive, not what you give. And what's important is you try your best, you just put in all the effort that you can. And I know for sure I can say that even if, again, the booth doesn't turn out the way I expected it to be, like let's say the sales are not as good or whatsoever, I can tell myself that, hey, I know I did my best and that is enough. Knowing that you did your best is enough. And maybe it's not the, you might still underestimate yourself thinking that I don't think it's my best, but you need to know what is in your control, what you've done your best to this knowledge or these materials that you have, like with whatever resources basically. You've done your best based on the resources that you have at the moment, based on the wisdom that you have at the moment, you've done your best. And what's beyond that is not in your control. So that is something that we also need to keep in mind, like knowing what is in your control and what isn't. Yeah. And yesterday I also managed to take a day off in a way to meet my friends. Had a meeting about an upcoming majlis this Saturday. So yeah, there's just a lot of things going on. And I think it's really nice to just sit down and have this little reflection. My room, current state of room, is a mess. And I honestly just want to escape, like part of me just wants to run away from all this for just like 5 minutes, just at least 5 minutes. Yeah. And yeah, as I mentioned from the start, I wanted to share with you guys like what exactly is happening. And I guess you can tell that I'm not like, I just want to be raw in terms of saying that, you know, the move is not as smooth as you might see, or like, you know, how others only show like their successes and all that. But I just want to show you guys how there are tough days whereby I feel like giving up whatsoever as well. And it's totally fine. I want to tell you guys that it's totally fine. I even had a breakdown just now, and it feels so good to just let it out, to know that God is there listening to you. God knows what you're going through. Allah knows what you're going through. And yeah, I guess it's a very beautiful feeling to be vulnerable in front of God. Like there's nothing to hide from Him, because He already knows, so might as well just show Him that side of you. Yeah, if you need to cry, if you're having a hard time, don't keep it in, let it out. Let it out in any way you feel is right. Whether you just want to cry it out for 5 minutes, whether you want to write it down, whether you want to talk to someone, whether you want to talk to Allah, whatever your platform is, just make sure you don't hold it back, because that's not healthy. But yeah, that's all. Yes, I still got so much more to do, but I think tonight I'm gonna take it slow. I'm just gonna list down what it is I have to do and then see whether I still need to push on for tonight. Else, if I can do it tomorrow, which is the last day before the proof, then I'll leave it to tomorrow. But else, I think I'm just gonna call it a day. Okay, also, like, that's my friend's book that he left at my place. But yeah, like usually that book, my niece would play with it, and for some reason it was on my table, and I didn't even realize when it came about. It was just like here. So I don't know, like something about that tells me that none of this is a coincidence, and like there is a reason why that book just ended on my table. Thanks to my niece partially, but yeah, it's there. And I don't know, I would just like to think that it's not a coincidence that the book happened to be there. And me looking at the book right now, of a picture of Habib Umar, a descendant of Rasulullah, you know, sometimes with all the chaos that's going on, you just need to be surrounded with the light of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and you just need to be reminded that things are gonna be okay. Even like, it's just so beautiful how the cover of the book is a picture of Habib Umar smiling, and I guess most of you can tell how contagious his smile is. Or not only his smile, like all the descendants of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, I can tell that you know, you can just feel it, you know, like his descendants, their smile, just something different about it, and it's really contagious. So I guess I'm gonna leave that book on my table to keep me motivated to for the rest of the days, to remind me that the light of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is what's gonna keep you going, is what's gonna keep you motivated, in that things are gonna be okay and you're gonna eventually smile once again. Yeah, inshallah, alhamdulillah.
Okay, so you know how like 5 seconds ago I just said how I want to run away and not look at the mess of my room, but I really can't stand it. And for me, I'm the kind of person who's like, you know, if you want something to happen, you need to make it happen. So right now, I am not going to sleep with this mess. I'm not gonna let this clutter take up my headspace. So I'm gonna clean it up, and I'm pretty sure I'll feel so much better after it. And
really trying to not put the expectation on myself for my room to be as clean this week, considering I have a booth, so like it's fine that it's so messy. It still pains my eyes and it clutters my mind, but I guess this is the best I can do as of now. And yeah, I shouldn't put expectation for it to be like sparkly clean or whatsoever, but I guess on the bright side, like at least I can see how much I've done. Like a lot might look messy, but a lot can also show that I've done this much, you know? Yeah. Positive thinking, y'alls. So you know how usually people are worried about making too little, but I feel like I did too much. And yeah, like I still haven't sought out or properly planned how I want to like set it up, because there's so many and I don't know whether I should display all of them or just a few, because I think if I were to display all, it would look too messy. So yeah, I still haven't decided yet, and my legs are aching for some reason, but yeah, anyway, I'm gonna take a break. It's about noon right now and I need to have my lunch. I am so extremely tired, but yeah, just one day left. Day one done! 30 minutes to open and I'm still setting up.